Hi, everybody. Welcome to Wilson Counseling for another Mental Health Minute. I was working with a client recently who was dealing with a lot of depression, wasn't feeling very good about herself or her life, was feeling kind of hopeless about being able to change. And I noticed when she was talking about herself, she talked about herself in very negative terms. One of the things that stuck out to me, she said, "I'm a failure at almost everything I've ever done, except for raising my children." And her kids, you could tell, were just the love of her lives. I mean, she would go on and on about how great they were and would just light up when she would speak about them. Clearly, she was a really attentive, loving, wonderful parent. Her children at this point, though, now are grown and have children of their own, so she doesn't have as much involvement with them. But when she would talk about them, she would talk about how great they were, and that was the one thing in her life that she felt good about. But the way she would talk about herself was as a failure. "I'm a failure at almost everything I've ever done, except for raising those kids." And I asked her, "Do you really feel that way? Do you feel like you're a failure at everything you've ever done?" And she said without hesitation, "Yes, I'm a failure at everything." And so I asked her, "Well, can you think of anything that you've ever done besides being a mom that you feel good about?" And she couldn't think of a single thing. And so I brought up a time that she had mentioned to me about some design work that she had helped her kids redesign. Their homes, redesign their kitchens and bathrooms and other areas of their houses. And she felt great about those things. I mean, she was talking about how cute the kitchen looked and how much more functional it was for her kids and how excited they were about the renovations. And so I brought that up to her and I said, "Well, you seem pretty happy with how the renovations went. Do you feel good about that?" And she said, "Yes." So I just pointed out the discrepancy that if she was a failure at everything besides being a parent, and yet she was really good at remodeling and design work, there was at least one other area of her life that she did feel good about, that she wasn't a failure. And she admitted, "You're right. That is something that I feel really good about." And so it caused her to rethink the way she looked at herself, because she'd been spending all this time talking about how useless she was, how she had never really done anything with her life, how she wasn't good at anything, how she was a failure. And I think a lot of us do that without noticing. We say really negative things to ourselves and about ourselves, and they affect how we feel. We start to feel more low, depressed. It starts to affect our self-esteem. Can you imagine if you heard yourself talking like that to anybody else? It might even be called abusive. So what are the ways in which you speak to yourself, think about yourself, talk about yourself that cause you to feel less than, cause you to feel like you're not valuable, you're not worthwhile? I would really encourage you to notice those beliefs, things like "I'm a failure," or "I'm not good at fill in the blank," "I'm useless," "I'm a waste of space." I've heard all of these things from different people over the years. But if you take some time to stop and really notice how that makes you feel, I would encourage you to challenge those beliefs. Notice where those beliefs are not really true and replace those negative beliefs with more positive statements. So instead of saying "I'm a failure," I think it would be fair to say something like, "I'm a work in progress. I'm really good at these things. I'm not as good at these other things." And you can be realistic and you can be honest about it, but you don't have to be belittling in the way that you talk about yourself. So I would encourage you to start by, first of all, making a note of any time where you say negative things about yourself. Write that down, put that in your phone or keep a note of it. And then take that list after a week of everything that you've said that's negative and challenge those statements and say, "Well, is there evidence for that? Or is there evidence to go against it?" And then replace those negative beliefs with something that's more neutral, more positive, and more loving. Think about, how would I talk to my child? How would I talk to my best friend? How would I talk to somebody I really loved and respected? And write down those statements instead, those positive statements, those affirming statements. And then practice saying those things to yourself in your head, encouraging yourself when you do good things, noticing positive things about yourself. And when there are negative things, instead of just berating yourself, come up with a plan, come up with a way that you can work on those things. And, you know, we're all a work in progress. I mean, nobody is perfect. Nobody's great at everything. And so it's okay to have a plan for changing the things that you think are worth changing without belittling yourself for those things. Well, I hope that that's been helpful to you guys.